We don't tend to say no. Unions are very powerful. The cops get tremendous representation. There's all kinds of money to pay additional salaries from the feds and the state. The issue is, you want to be a cop, even for $100,000 a year. Why? Do something wrong, you are looking at possibly jail time. You're looking at liability. Oh, incidentally, the other thing the unions provide is representation. Derek Chauvin didn't pay a dime for his representation. It was paid for by the union, because that's their collective bargaining agreement. Okay, there's no labor shortage out there, right? Actually, there's just not enough good jobs, but there's a real dichotomy. There's a contradiction there I want to share with you. The number of jobs available, the number of people that are working, the desperation of business owners. I mean, you put all that together and you've got a cauldron of a mess. So I'll share that with you when we come back. KFI AM 640 live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app.
Okay, guys, everybody ready?
Happy 4th of July.
I'm landing it.
May you have as many fingers and eyeballs on the 5th as you did on the 3rd.
Oh, wait, it went out.
Just looking out for you.
Ah!
You're welcome.
KFI.
And KOST HD2.
Los Angeles, Orange County.
Live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app.
Partially evacuated. I'm Jennifer Jones Lee, live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. As Handel mentioned, part of LAX has been evacuated because of a bomb scare. The ticketing area of Terminal 2 has been cleared out until a bomb squad can come in and check out a suspicious package. We'll let you know if there are any changes. The ATF's National Response Team is on the scene of that massive illegal fireworks explosion that happened when the LAPD bomb squad was trying to destroy some improvised explosive devices in South LA. The ATF's Monica Villegas says the team will comb through the debris field.
We have certified explosive specialists and certified fire investigators that come out. They're veterans. They come from all over the country.
The explosion Wednesday night happened after bomb techs located the explosives and put them in a total containment vehicle. Moments later, there was a special containment vehicle destroyed and dozens of cars were damaged. At least 17 people were injured, 10 of whom are police officers. Cases of COVID-19 in L.A. County have doubled in the past couple of weeks.
Health Director Barbara Ferrer says she's a little worried about fully vaccinated people who are still capable of getting the virus and or at least spreading the virus to those who are not vaccinated.
Among these fully vaccinated 4.5 million people, we've identified 2,190 people who tested positive for a COVID infection, contracted more than 2 weeks after they were fully vaccinated.
Ferrer says she's also concerned about the rapid spread of the Delta variant, which accounts for 47% of the latest cases in the county. Steve Gregory, KFI News.
California's Attorney General has put up a red flag over gun sales.
2020 saw the largest year-over-year increase in handgun sales ever for California and the second highest jump for long guns.
Legal gun sales do not automatically equate to a violent incident.
But AG Rob Bonta says when shootings happen, there are often signs beforehand, and with more guns owned, he says people should be more aware of red flag laws.
These laws can be a proactive tool to help prevent gun violence, but they are not being used enough.
He says people can ask the court for a temporary restraining order if someone threatens violence to themselves or others. Chris Ancarlo, KFI News.
Wildfires in Northern California have burned dozens of homes and buildings and forced thousands of people to leave their communities, mainly in the mountains. Authorities say three wildfires near Mount Shasta have burned about 50 square miles of land. The biggest fire is in Siskiyou County, where 3,500 people have had to leave their homes. A massive heat wave that started multiple wildfires has now forced thousands of people to leave their homes in a province of British Columbia in Canada. One town was destroyed by a fire a day after it was 121 degrees there. That's the hottest temperature ever recorded in Canada. And a retired nun from Torrance, who's admitted to stealing $835,000 from a Catholic school to gamble, has been released as she waits for her next court appearance. The 79-year-old woman is set to go back to federal court at the end of the month to plead guilty to stealing money from St. James Catholic School, where she was the principal, as part of an agreement with prosecutors. She's now facing up to 40 years in prison. We've got a crash on the 60.
It's in Rubidoux. On the 60 westbound before Rubidoux Boulevard. Injuries involved here. Maybe three cars. Carpool in left lane taken away. That's going to jam things up right around the 215-91. KFI in the Sky, sponsored by injury attorney Superwoman, Superlawyer.com. Jeff Baugh, update on the 170.
Well, this was a pretty bad crash. Now, we had to leave this a few minutes ago. Burbank Airport was getting kind of busy. And then you go surf that around there. But North 170 past Victory, we had the carpool, two left lanes blocked. And when we left, the flatbeds were towing the last of the vehicles. So I hope it's cleared by now. But even if it hasn't, with the two right lanes open, the backup isn't all that bad. It was from Oxnard, which is just before you get up to Victory. So not too bad. North of that, things were good. One of you is Laurel. That's still in pretty good shape up to Sherman Way. Get on there. Southbound, a little spectator slowing. The South 5, right in Van Nuys Boulevard, just south of the 118, is a right shoulder problem. Wasn't lanes, obviously. Really slow from before the 118, but then things will improve. And real quick here, if you heard the headlines from Jennifer at LAX, boy, getting into LAX has turned into a nightmare. Southbound coming in from Westchester on Sepulveda, it's all jammed up solid trying to use that 96 through the engines. Even northbound Sepulveda, make some calls. This is really going to slow you down. More on that coming up. Injured in an accident, visit Superwoman, Superlawyer.com. Jeff Baugh, KFI in the Sky.
Working this crash in Santa Ana on the 5 South before 17th. It's the carpool lane you can't use. Rough drive from the Orange Crush Interchange. KFI Sky helps get you there faster. I'm Robin Banks.
The Dodgers waited until the fourth inning against the Nationals to get on the board. That was courtesy of an RBI single from Albert Pujols. The fifth inning saw A.J. Pollock launch a solo dinger, and then this from Max Muncy.
A ball, right field, and it is gone! A grand slam home run for Max Muncy, his 18th home run of the year, and the Dodgers have themselves a 6-2 lead.
And that was it, because right after the fifth inning, a severe weather delay ended play. They never resumed. The game was called, giving LA a 6-2 win. Game two today at 4:05. Julio Urias will start. The Angels-Yankees series closer didn't happen at all thanks to weather. It's been postponed to August 16th. The Halos are now home to host the Orioles, and that game starts at 6:38 this evening. Griffin Canning will start on the mound at Angel Stadium. I'm Wayne Resnick, KFI Sports.
If you're looking to get out of your house, moving, downsizing, you have financial issues, maybe you inherited the house, so typically you're going to call a realtor. That's what everybody does. And the realtor is going to come out, take a look at your house. Okay, you got to repair, you got to paint. All those tchotchkes that you think are beautiful that are ugly, you got to throw those in a closet. And you can't be around when potential buyers walk through the house. But let me give you another way of doing it. You get a fair price without any of that. The buyer never walks through your house, no appraisal, no commissions, no fees. Most importantly, the junk you have on all your surfaces, you can keep right there. And you can get paid in cash. I'm talking fast, 10 days or less. That's directbuyers.com. Directbuyers.com. This is a business where there's a lot of schlocks out there. Matt and Janet, brother and sister, don't work that way. I like the way they do business. They're honest. Matter of fact, they're going to give you an honest, no-obligation offer, and they can even get you $15,000 cash advance before closing to help with your move. And they'll never, ever lowball you. Go to directbuyers.com, directbuyers.com. Call 844-242-SELL, directbuyers.com.
Discover a new gaming experience that's out of this world at San Manuel Casino. Find your new favorite slots and table games, unforgettable promotions, and dining experiences that put us above the rest. Up the ante by joining our members' rewards program, Club Serrano, and unlock special discounts, promotions, and so much more. Discover the future of all thrill only at San Manuel Casino. Must be 21 to enter the casino. Please gamble responsibly. 1-800-GAMBLER.
Your KFI Financial Report is brought to you by Bay Alarm. The Dow is up 44, S&P up 13, NASDAQ up 41, gold is $17.83 an ounce, and oil is $74.79 a barrel. The KFI Money Report is brought to you by Bay Alarm. Protect your business with a monitored video verification system. Visit BayAlarm.com to get protected today. Sunny and warm again today with highs 70 at the beaches, upper 70s to the mid-80s for Metro LA and OC, low 90s to right at 100 for the valleys in the IE. Copy and paste that forecast for tomorrow and just a couple of degrees cooler inland for the 4th of July. Right now it's 64 in Dana Point, 67 in Orange, 66 in Downey, 68 in Mission Hills. We lead local, live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. I'm Jennifer Jones Lee.
A lot going on today. The rescue efforts at the collapsed Florida condominium building resumed last night after a 15-hour pause for safety concerns. There was some shifting, and the engineers thought it was the building adjacent to the debris field. It wasn't. It was the debris field itself, so they're back. And we now have a date for the recall election of Gavin Newsom. It's September 14th. One of the big stories that are coming out as we're getting out of pandemic, except for the fact we have the Delta variant, which is now bringing us back in pandemic. You just watch, because it's the transmissibility of this thing is just crazy. And it's people who are not going to be vaccinated that are getting it. So coming out of the pandemic, everything is, for the most part, we're moving quickly into our economy, a real economy. Las Vegas, for example, in May had their biggest single month in history in terms of profits. I mean, it is crazy stuff. So, labor shortage, right? Well, there is a labor shortage, but the reality is there are not enough good jobs. That is the problem. Because if you're a server, you're still a server. And if your skill set is you are putting hamburgers on the counter at a fast food restaurant, it's still the same job. Now, granted, it's going to be $15 an hour instead of 12 bucks an hour, because we're very quickly moving into that realm, which we should. Matter of fact, I'm one of those people that believe you need a living wage. If you're willing to work 40 hours a week, you have to be able to eat. You got to be able to feed yourself at least, and we in America don't do that. Federal minimum wage is still $7.25, and there are places that pay $7.25 that don't have state minimums. A lot of states in the South, you can get that. Nevada, their jobs is $7.25 because there's no state law that increases the pay. So the point is, it's the good jobs where there is a huge labor shortage, and this is the jobs that people want. Because they're the skill jobs, the employers, they want to pay, and those are relatively few and far between, because those jobs, for the most part, are not retail. You didn't have to interact with the public. High-tech jobs, not manufacturing jobs, not putting stuff together in a factory. Even though that happened, but we're talking about your white-collar jobs. Sales jobs, for example, here at KFI, we're just starting to get some salespeople back. And I could go back there and harass salespeople. It's a wonderful thing. So the issue is, what do employers do? Here's what the economists are telling us. Oh boy, it's a whole new world. It's not. This is going to be very short-lived. And we're going to go back to where we effectively were, except there'll be higher wages. There's the new baseline. A couple of trends are emerging. Jobs hitting smaller businesses disproportionately being hit because there are so many jobs, because all of those jobs, fast food, restaurant jobs, disappeared. And now a lot of people had to get other jobs. A lot of people don't want to do that work anymore. My daughter Barbara is a server at a restaurant, and she comes home after 6 hours, seven-hour shift, and she's standing up and running around. I mean, her feet are killing her. I mean, every night. It's a tough job, and people go, you know, I don't want to do that. You know, why should I have to come home and have my feet hurt for hours at a time until the next day? Restaurant jobs are begging. So those are the trends. It didn't used to be that way. I mean, before the pandemic, anybody would grab any job. And what most people do, and this is a given, you go out, you send your resume out. or you go and interview, and if you're offered a job, the first one you get, you grab it. First time someone says yes, a potential employer says yes, you go, okay, you hired. Okay, I got it. Those days, as of right now, are gone. Because the studies are showing that those hospitality jobs, and that is where the hit is really hospitality. This is why California is getting hit far worse than other states. Our unemployment is twice that of other states when it comes to hospitality because we have so much hospitality. Now, when it comes to places like Las Vegas, which is 100% hospitality, that city was wiped out. And now it's coming back with a vengeance. Why? Because there are no other jobs. See, they don't have manufacturing jobs out there. They don't have high-tech jobs. We do. And that's where people have come to. So, as you think there is a new way of living, it's true. There really is a whole new paradigm here. But it's not for low-end paying jobs. It's going to be the same. There'll be more money, which is great. $15 an hour. Well, let me put it this way. Today's wages give you less spending power than what people were earning in the 70s. Dollar per dollar. So the ability to buy has declined year after year. And how do you do that to someone who works and is willing to work and is willing to wake up and go out there and put in the 8 hours? I mean, to me, that's a Shonda. You know, that's a shame. Climate change, you know, for those of you that don't believe in climate change, go get a sandwich because this next segment is not for you. For those of you that do believe in climate change, and especially if you're in wildfire areas, we're going to limit this to California, who should pay? Should you pay? Should the government pay? Insurance companies? Do you force the insurance companies? Do you mandate that you stay here and pick up fire insurance, for example? I'll come back with that let's check in with Jennifer Jones late.
The all clear has been given at LAX after a suspicious package was found this morning. Terminal 2 was evacuated while the LAPD bomb squad investigated, but passengers now are going back inside. China's rejected accusations by the U.S. that it's failing to stop human trafficking and said Washington has no right to criticize. Beijing was among 17 governments that were warned of potential U.S. sanctions over human trafficking. And today is weigh-in day for those competing in the Nathan's famous 4th of July hot dog eating contest. There will be a live audience this year. Multi-time champ Joey Chestnut scarfed down 75 dogs last year. The women's champ Mickey Sudo ate a record 48 and a half dogs. We've got a crash on the 5 we'll look at with EKFI in the sky next.
Summer's here, which means you're drinking more water. You should drink plenty anyway, but you're simply sucking up more water. And what do you do? Plastic water bottles, and you toss those water bottles away. It's a disaster for the environment. And so let me suggest doing what I did years ago, and that's buy a Life Source whole house water filtration system, put one in your house. And there's a few things that the Life Source system does, which is kind of neat. First of all, it delivers clean, great tasting, safe water out of every single faucet in your home. Effectively, every faucet delivers filtered great water, certainly as good as bottled water in my experience. No filter changes, I mean, none of that. Once it's installed, you're done. It gets rid of the odor and taste of chlorine, no salt, no chemicals. You're bathing, washing clothes, washing dishes, effectively in bottled water. That's the Life Source water filtration system. In celebration of July 4th, and this is through July 9th, that's when the offer ends, Life Source water will pay your sales tax. Call 800-334-5009, 800-334-5009. Visit LifeSourceWater.com. LifeSource Water, taste and feel the difference.
MyAccidentLawyer.com, tired of the BS? We spent $500,000 of our money at risk. Result, $8 million for leg-injured motorcyclists.
MyAccidentLawyer is the way to go. Call 800-920-0810.
Robert Coley, Esquire. Results may vary, no guarantee.
SoCal weather from KFI. It's a sunny Friday with highs from the low 70s at the coast to right at 100 inland. This report is brought to you by iAccidentLawyer.com. Let's check out this crash on the 5.
It's in Commerce on the 5 southbound just before Atlantic. Looks like they just moved everybody from the left lane over to the right shoulder, so that is good news. You're still going to have to fight your way through that leftover backup, though, right around Calzona. KFI in the Sky is sponsored by entry attorney Superwoman, SuperLawyer.com. Jeff Baugh, West San Fernando Valley.
You betcha, and things looking pretty good, actually. If you're leaving Agoura Hills, Calabasas coming into the San Fernando Valley, that eastbound 101 is looking good, really, all the way to the 405, no problems there. Now, we took a little flight over the Las Virgenes and Topanga, kind of in between the 101 and getting close to them. Malibu, still covered in low clouds, so never see the sun there today, but all the drives are pretty good, even Las Virgenes going down to Paioma and Topanga down to Fernwood, so things were pretty good there. Now, we're going to head back to the 170 and make sure that's all gone. If you just joined us, there was a problem. I hope it's cleared. North 170 around Victory. A little slowing there, but more on that coming up. Injured in an accident, visit Superwoman, SuperLawyer.com. Jeff Fogg, KFI in the Sky.
Still working in Rubidoux on the 60 westbound before Rubidoux Boulevard. Carpool and left lane are blocked. Heavy traffic from the 215-91. KFI in the Sky helps get you there faster. I'm Robin Banks.
This report is sponsored by Mercury Insurance. A 7-minute detour to get a quote with Mercury Insurance could save you hundreds on your car insurance. That's way more money than your GPS traffic app has ever saved you. So take a trip to MercuryInsurance.com to get a fast, free quote and start saving today.
Look, staying healthy isn't easy. Watching your diet, hitting the gym, avoiding stress. But a good night's rest helps boost your overall health and wellness. And it couldn't be easier. The new Sleep Number 360 Smart Bed is the only bed that effortlessly adjusts in response to both of you. The result? You wake up ready for anything. Proven quality sleep is life-changing sleep. Don't miss our 4th of July special. The new Queen Sleep Number 360 C2 Smart Bed is only $899. Plus free premium delivery when you add a base. Ends Monday. To learn more, go to sleepnumber.com.
Ready to turn your destination daydreams into reality?
I want to break free!
Norwegian Cruise Line's Freedom Sale is back and better than ever. For a limited time, enjoy 30% off, free open bar, free airfare, and more. Break free this summer to the Caribbean, Europe, or other amazing destinations. With our leading health and safety program, you can cruise with the ultimate freedom. Book today at ncl.com. Call your travel advisor or 1-888-NCL-CRUISE. Offer ends soon. Norwegian Cruise Line. Sail safe. Feel free. Ships registered to Bahamas and USA. Restrictions apply.
Attention, savvy investors. Are you looking to hedge against inflation and receive steady monthly cash flow? How about the safety and security of a real estate investment without the hassles of being a landlord? Maybe you should cash out of some stock market risk and volatility and take some money off the table. Instead, receive 10% annualized monthly payouts with bonuses targeted to 21%. NRIA is an industry-leading real estate development firm in its 15th year constructing strategically located, lower-risk, high-demand properties in unique neighborhoods based on supply-demand imbalance. Call 800-814-14 to start your due diligence. A great fit for safety-oriented investors desiring monthly cash flow and diversification into carefully curated real estate. Learn more about the NRIA Real Estate Development Fund at NRIA.net or call 800-814-14. That's 800-814-14.
An offer of securities is only made by the NRIA Private Placement Memorandum. Read it first. Past performance does not guarantee future results. NRIA is a real estate development firm. Learn more at NRIA.net.
I'm celebrating July 4th with a massage, dinner at Cielo, and playing blackjack, just like the Founding Fathers intended.
And now, the top 5 reasons to visit Morongo. Number 5.
Good times are going on at the Oasis Pool. In the sun, on the sand, or down the lazy river. Get a day pass today.
Number 4.
American Traveler Giveaway. You can get a sleek laptop bag when you earn 500 points on your rewards card the 5th or 6th.
3.
4th of July freebie. Rewards members get a free July 4th Morongo t-shirt while supplies last.
Number 2.
Games. Morongo's got big screens throughout the casino, so you can watch all the games while playing games.
And the number one reason.
July 4th deals at Good Times Cafe. Barbecue beef brisket, plus 3 sides and cheesecake, all for one low price.
Morongo Casino Resort and Spa. Morongo. Good times!
It's Conway here. Are you looking to sell your home fast without doing any repairs? Then you need to call my friends at Sunday. Sunday will buy your home as is and give you the best possible price. Sunday buys homes off market in any condition. Here's how it works. If you have a gated property or an inherited property that you can't or don't want to keep, or even a house with structural issues, or a house that you simply don't want to fix up in order to sell, call Sunday to get your no obligation cash offer. With Sunday, you don't have the hassle with showings, cleanings, repairs, or even realtor fees. Sunday will give you an immediate cash offer and can close on your timeline in as quick as 10 days. The process is so easy, you can even get a $10,000 cash advance if you need cash prior to closing. So go to Sunday.com, that's S-U-N-D-A-E.com, that's Sunday.com, S-U-N-D-A-E.com, or call them, 825-OFFER. That's 800-25-OFFER.
57% of Republicans say the pandemic's over and only 4% of Democrats. Are people in reality distortion bubbles?
Yeah, separate universes.
How could there possibly be a political viewpoint on whether you think the pandemic is over?
Aren't they following the science? What's so hard about that?
What if the variant breaks through?
John and Ken. What if an air conditioner falls on my head?
Weekdays at 2 on KFI.
AM 640 Handle here, Friday morning, July the 2nd. Big stories we're covering. We have a recall election date. Newsom, it's going to be September 14th over in Florida. Rescue efforts continue on after a 15-hour pause because of some structural issues. And Dodgers pitcher Trevor Bauer has been accused of sexual assault. He's expected to make a start on Sunday. Dodgers are saying, you know what? And Major League Baseball is handling this. They haven't said anything to us.
But we did get the all clear at LAX Terminal 2. It was evacuated earlier because of that suspicious package. LAPD bomb squad came in, said, you're good to go, and the passengers are heading back inside.
Okay. And then the package will be delivered to intended recipient by Amazon, right? Which is fine. Thank you for that.
Okay.
When it comes to climate change, there are several aspects of it. There's big picture, the entire world. There is sort of medium picture, and that is what do cities, counties, etc. Then you've got small picture, which is you dealing with it. And then you got the business side of it. And on the business side of it, when you climate change equals wildfires, so we know there's a connection there. As I said, if you don't believe in climate change, go get a sandwich. This segment is not for you. So what do we do with the wildfires? Well, certainly without insurance, your house burns or severely damaged, you're done. I mean, you can get loans through FEMA and the federal government. You got to pay those back. Insurance, you don't pay back because you pay your premiums every month or every year. And so here's the problem. Insurance is so expensive. You've got companies that don't want to deal with fire insurance anymore. So who pays for all this? It was like floods in Mississippi where people just stay there for the 15th time they didn't flood it out because there's flood insurance, federal flood insurance. And so are we on our way to have something similar? Well, we sort of do in California. If you can't get insurance, you're in a fire zone and there's plenty of insurance companies saying, no, we're not going to insure there. You're done. And let me tell you, the panic is there. There's something called the FAIR Plan. It's run by the state, and it is the last resort where you pay an astronomical premium, and all you get is fire insurance. Now, normally fire insurance is part of your homeowner's policy. Now, theft, people breaking in, liability, a pipe burst, whatever, it's all part of your homeowner's policy. Which most of us have. Well, under the FAIR Plan, it just is when your house catches fire, and then you are, it pays you, but you pay a fortune for it. So here comes the question, which way do we go on this? Now, the insurance commissioner actually has the ability, California insurance commissioner, has the ability to force the insurance companies to offer fire insurance. Now, he doesn't actually say you must offer. What he says, if you don't offer, you're out of here. You're not selling any insurance in California, which there are some major insurers who said, that's fine. We're not making enough money anywhere. We're losing our shirts. Incidentally, the major insurance companies are down, about $20 billion in the last few years. They've been losing money like crazy, which is why they're gone. I mean, it's a simple economic issue. You lose money, you get out of the business. You make money, you stay in. How is that for a deep economic lesson? So the legislature, they're trying to figure out, state legislature, who is responsible for the cause caused by natural disasters? And You also have an issue. Do you, by law, say you can't build in those areas? You can't get a building permit because more and more people want to live out near the trees and want to live out in the forests, which means burn areas. If there is insurance to be had by a major insurance company and you happen to live in what they call a burn area, and that is an area that's prone to being victim of fires, your house is more apt to catch on fire because of a wildfire, be prepared to pay, I don't know, three times as much as I pay for my house because I'm not in a burn area. So that is what is going through the legislature right now, trying to figure out what do we do? How do we pay for it? How do we deal with insurance? What do we mandate? Do we go to the feds? Because not only is the state trying to deal with the wildfires themselves, new technology, equipment, new airplanes. I think LA County just bought two massive helicopters to deal with wildfires, and they're changing their procedures and policies all the time. But also, it's the financial issue, and how does this all get paid for? Well, sitting on the legislature, and they have debates like crazy. Coming up, Handle on the News Late Edition, and it is a super segment. No commercials till the end of the top of the hour. So we won't be taking a commercial break midway through, which, of course, our advertisers absolutely love. This is KFI AM 640. Let's check in with Jennifer.
More people are being killed in California.
Murders in the state jumped 31% last year, making 2020 the deadliest in 13 years. State reports show there were more than 2,200 homicides, 523 more than in 2019. Four experts from UC Berkeley's Policy Lab say cities in California generally did better than those in other states that saw bigger per capita increases in murder. Black people make up 6.5% of California's population, but accounted for 31% of those killed last year. 45% were Latino and 16% were white. Deborah Mark, KFI News.
News is brought to you by the Cunning Dental Group. The LA City Council has agreed to a partial ban on sleeping and camping on sidewalks. Councilman Joe Buscaino says the ordinance makes sure the critical right-of-ways are clear.
This ordinance does not criminalize homelessness any more than banning parking in front of the fire hydrant criminalizes drivers.
Councilwoman Nithya Raman voted against the ordinance in part because of lack of discussion.
This was a quick and hasty process, and it was done behind closed doors.
Raman was one of two dissenters, which means the measure can't go into effect until a second procedural vote by the council. The California Department of Fish and Wildlife is investigating the shooting death of a cougar in the Santa Ana Mountains. The big cat was found earlier this week. Karina Domingo, the head of the Cougar Conservancy, says the organization has been working to educate people in the area about cougars.
You know, it's a complicated issue, and we're really trying to do everything we can to kind of empower local communities to coexist with cougars because it's just so important, and it's important to the population as well.
The male cougar, who was known as Scar and El Cobre, was estimated to be about 5 years old. The Supreme Court has declined to hear an appeal on whether businesses have the right to refuse services for same-sex weddings. The case involves a woman in Washington State who refused to provide flowers for a same-sex wedding, arguing it violated her religious beliefs. She was found by a lower court to have broken a law that forbids discrimination based on sexual orientation. The Supreme Court also declined to hear an appeal from a man in Colorado who refused to bake a cake for same-sex couples 3 years ago. The CDC says the Delta variant is causing case numbers around the country to go up.
While this is a 95% decrease, lower from our peak in early January, it does also reflect a 10% increase in the seven-day average from last week.
CDC Director Dr. Rochelle Walensky says the vaccines provide the best protection against the more infectious strain, but many areas still have low vaccination rates. We're watching this wreck on the 71.
It's in Pomona. On the northbound 71, just before Ranch Road, several vehicles collided. They are in traffic lanes. Big old traffic jam from the 60 for you. KFI in the Sky is sponsored by injury attorney Superwoman, Superlawyer.com. Jeff Baugh, 170.
You betcha. You've been listening for a while now. This is a big old traffic jam is all gone. was quite a crash, though. Northbound 170 past Victory, people hurt and cars all over the place, but all lanes have been reopened for a while now. So if you're coming off that West 134 to the North 170 or even the 101 Hollywood Freeway, it's a good drive now, right up to the merge with the North 5 and up towards San Fernando, the 118 and all that stuff. The 101 has calmed down a little bit. It was a little busy around the 405, but not now. Really coming out of the San Fernando Valley all the way over towards Laurel. It gets a little slow going in the Hollywood Freeway, but not too bad. And then you pick up the East 134, still good into Glendale. Injured in an accident, visit Superwoman, superlawyer.com. Jeff Baugh, KFI in the sky.
El Monte on the eastbound side of the 10, right at Santa Anita. Two cars here, partially blocking the right lane. Some very, I don't know, just barely there slowing eastbound from about Walnut Grove. KFI in the sky helps get you there faster. I'm Robin Bay.
The Angels' Mike Trout was voted an All-Star Game starter, but he can't play because he's on the 60-day injured list. Shohei Ohtani's win for the designated hitter position came with a whopping 63% of the vote. In the National League, the Dodgers had five players as finalists, but none of them made the starting roster. The All-Star Game will take place in Denver on July 13th. I'm Wayne Rasnick, KFI Sports.
Here's what you don't want to have happen to you, which did happen to me. And that is, I went on vacation, came home, my house was flooded. Well, you wake up and your house is flooded. Maybe a pipe bursts and they've got, you know, just water all over the place. And, of course, a lot of damage. So the first thing you want to do is call your insurance company. And that's what people do. The problem, that's the wrong phone call to make. Because they'll send out an adjuster and tell you what they don't cover. And tell you what they won't pay for. Because insurance companies, they're experts at not paying. Because their loyalty actually is to their shareholders. So let me tell you about someone who's loyal to you and you only and represents you against the insurance company. And that's Abner Gatt. Abner is a public insurance adjuster who negotiates on your behalf. And now you have a level playing field because he knows exactly what the insurance companies do and don't do. And he says, okay, that's not going to fly. He's been at it for 16 years, thousands of satisfied customers. That's Abner Gatt. Flooding, that's who to call. Call Abner at 818-917-5256, 818-917-5256. Visit Abner Gatt, A-V-N-E-R Gatt, just like it sounds, AbnerGatt.com.
SoCal weather from KFI. We've got a sunny Friday ahead, a lot like yesterday. Highs will range from the low 70s at the beaches, mid-80s for Metro LA and OC, low 90s to right at 100 for the valleys in the IE. More of the same tomorrow, and then for your 4th of July, just a few degrees cooler inland. We lead local, live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. I'm Jennifer Jones-Lee.
Sign on the line, 8 DBH Mortgage is a fair housing lender. And NMLS, 162-6699.
Some wild things happened in home lending while we were filling in for Handle. The government came out with a new program for homeowners that may have missed out on the lowest rates in lending history.
The government enacted a program just days ago giving homeowners relief on refinancing their homes this very minute.
It's called Refi Now, and millions of homeowners are eligible. You can call True Mortgage, 866-33-FASTER, or go to truenow.com right now. See if you qualify for this government program.
Here's the thing, it literally takes less than 5 minutes to see if you qualify. This program has one of the biggest government breaks regarding mortgage qualification guidelines ever.
It's true, credit requirements have been loosened by the federal government and rates have been reduced even lower, even for those who are self-employed.
If you're a homeowner and missed out on the lowest rates or couldn't refi, this is your time, but do it today before the program runs out.
Give them a call, 833-66-FASTER, or go to truenow.com. 833-66-FASTER, or dial #250 and say True Mortgage. That's #250, True Mortgage.
This 4th of July at Grocery Outlet, stock up on snacks with Frito-Lay party-sized chips. Assorted varieties are buy two, get one free. Also, don't forget the ice. 7-pound bags are just 99 cents.
There's never been a better time to switch to Spectrum Mobile. You could save hundreds of dollars on your mobile bill. Plus, there are no added taxes, hidden fees, and no contracts. Try the Spectrum Mobile Savings Calculator today, and in three easy steps, you'll see how much you could save by switching. Visit SpectrumMobile.com/save. Spectrum Internet required. Savings may vary. Restrictions apply. Visit SpectrumMobile.com/save for details.
Portions of the following program were pre-recorded.
KFI AM 640.
An iHeart radio station.
24-hour news. More stimulating talk.
Handle on the News. Late edition.
Handle on the News.
Jesus Christ, that's
Bill Handle.
And it is time for Handle on the News Late Edition, and it is a super segment, which means to the top of the hour, no ads, no spots, no commercials, no revenue for KFI, no money for you, management. They love these super segments, you know that? You guys ready to do it?
Yes, sir.
Handle on the News Late Edition, Jennifer, Wayne, and me, lead story. And I'm going to go right to Jennifer about this because the suspicious item at LAX Terminal 2, the latest on that.
Well, they have cleared it. So whatever it was, whatever the suspicious package was, they found it this morning. They evacuated Terminal 2, made everybody get out, called in the LAPD bomb squad, but the bomb squad made quick work of it. Whatever the investigation into it was, they quickly determined it was okay. All clear was given, and passengers are back inside.
Right, and this is Terminal 2, which is an international terminal, not just Tom Bradley, and Aeromexico. Oh, that's good. Air Canada, you're not going to get on. Canada Jazz, never heard of that. Air China, they won't let you on. Air New Zealand, you're not going. Alitalia, I don't think you can get into Italy. They evacuated the terminal and no one was there because no one could fly into those countries. But at least we have open terminals for you to just hang out and enjoy yourself and run your skateboards through. All right, let's go right into story number two.
Well, the LAPD now is also investigating what in the world happened with that detonation of the homemade fireworks in South L.A. this week, where 17 people were hurt, including 10 police officers in this. But they say it could take days to figure out why the material exploded inside that total containment vehicle that they had, blew the top right off the darn thing.
Yeah, so was it, I'm assuming the containment vehicle was closed.
Yes. Oh, yeah. They had put the stuff in it, and they closed it up. Right. And then all of a sudden, the boom happens. And so they brought the ATF in, which is looking now to help in the investigation. They are bringing, you know, throwing everything at this to see what sort of catastrophic failure happened where to cause this.
Well, yesterday we had good unemployment claims news. Now we have good jobs news.
Yeah, we do.
Economy added 850,000 jobs in June. Now, the unemployment rate went up 0.1%, but that's because the unemployment rate is based on carefully selected data that doesn't, it's not a question of how many people in the country don't have a job.
Right.
You have to be actively looking for jobs.
Right.
To be part of the population that's
coming. And when people come back, for example, let's say you add 850,000 jobs, but now 1 million people are now entering the workforce. Then the unemployment rate actually goes up.
Right.
So the, it's, they're weird right. numbers. I mean, there's U2, there's U5, there's, you know, there's just really weird numbers.
The trend here is great, though. Fewer people are being laid off. More people are getting jobs.
All right. I don't know who is tweeting for the White House now, but this is a very groan-worthy sort of dad joke-ish tweet that came from the White House about a cheaper 4th of July cookout. It says, planning a cookout this year. Catch up on the news.
Mm.
According to the Farm Bureau, the cost of a 4th of July barbecue is down from last year. It's a fact you must hear.
Yeah.
Hot dog or hot dog. The Biden economic plan is working, and that's something we can all relish.
Now, I have a question. The Biden administration is getting a lot of grief for you. Don't they have a right to have bad, bad puns so people think that whoever wrote that pun's an idiot?
Yes.
Sure. We have the right to do that.
Sure.
Yes, except we get mocked, too.
But sure. That's not, it's not just mocking the grownness of those puns. It's also that they carefully selected examples. of things where the prices are down from last year, like ground beef and sliced cheese and potato chips, but they didn't want to deal with the fact that overall the consumer price index for your groceries is up.
But that never happens whenever any administration is touting it. They're never going to say, let me give you the bad news.
It's always the something shiny. Look over here.
Always. I think the idea is, and I agree with this, you get one. You can give us good news data by carefully selecting what you tell us. You can do that. Or you can do dumb dad jokes in your tweet, not both at the same time.
Yeah. So, Neil, I give you from the good news desk.
Yes.
Right? And the world could literally be falling apart. There could be an earthquake here where the building is collapsing around you, and you're going to come up with a good news story.
But a dog who ran away when he was scared by fireworks later came back and rang the doorbell at his house.
Yeah.
It was a true story.
Yeah.
Stop it, I'm teary.
I know.
Okay. Attorney General Merrick Garland has ordered a temporary suspension of federal executions. There were 13 executions in the last 7 months of the former administration. Now there aren't going to be any for the foreseeable future. And listen, under this administration,
you're
not going to see one.
No, you won't see them.
There's only 46 people on federal death row.
Justice Sonia Mayor wrote in her opinion on January 15th about executions. It was a case in which executions were allowed to go forward. To put it in historical context, the feds will have executed more than three times as many people in the last 6 months than in the previous six decades. So